You're tuning into Black and White Sports on YouTube. The no-holds-barred truth on sports. The main event starts now.
All right, Black and White Sports supporters. It looks like the Arizona Cardinals are, I'm not going to say steamrolling, but slowly edging towards actually starting Kyler Murray. You might be like, well, wait a minute, I thought Kyler Murray was gone. Well, hold on now. Just because Kyler Murray might end up starting, let's say, the back half of the season, some are saying, in fact, Ian Rappaport is saying, the Falcons game with an outside chance of bringing him back against the Browns. Do you really want to bring him back against that defense? Little Kyler Murray, you want to bring him back against what looks like statistically through five games is literally the best defense in 50 years? I kind of doubt it. I mean, we saw what they did to Brock Purdy and the San Francisco 49ers on that Browns defense, so I would guess it's going to end up being the Falcons. But they're edging towards bringing him back, and you may be like, well, so they're keeping him. Well, not so fast, my friend. Maybe not, okay? Because the Cardinals may be working, and of course everybody thinks the Cardinals would be in on Caleb Williams. We'll get to some of his reaction 2 weeks in a row. It hasn't turned out for Caleb Williams like everybody would hoped it would, or at least he hoped it would, and it was evident visually last night. I noticed people are starting to get more and more skeptical of Caleb Williams as we get closer. I know some statistics came out about Caleb's performance against top 25 defenses, and it's not great. It's not really good either, okay? And one knows when you get to the NFL, windows close. Wide-ass open receivers aren't a thing. By the way, USC lost last night for the second straight week. They are officially out of the college football playoff. You can figure on that unless something dramatically drastic happens. So let's get to this. This is Ian Rappaport this morning. The Cardinals open the practice window for Kyler Murray this week. The first step towards a return to the football field following ACL surgery. So you may be like, well, wait a minute. If they want to let him go, why would they do this? Now, there is a risk in this. All right? So if they bring him back, he's on that massive contract, what's deemed very much around the league now as a bad contract. That contract's bad. Russell Wilson, Deshaun Watson, those three contracts are considered the three worst in football. If they bring him back and he gets hurt again, a little quarterback, then they're on the hook. And that could be a real problem. And then his trade value plummets. Now, here's the other problem. It's a catch-22 because if you don't bring him back and showcase that he's healthy, who the hell's going to want to trade for him anyway? So the Cardinals are kind of stuck, but I don't think they're doing this to bring him back and keep him, all right? Even if he lights the world on fire, I think the Cardinals, if you gave them truth serum, are going to be like Caleb Williams, Drake Maye, Michael Pennix Jr. is going to be the three names the Cardinals are already thinking about, all right? I think Murray's departure is already a given at this point. I believe that anyway. Sources say Murray's return is expected to take multiple weeks, with the most likely outcome that he practices for 3 weeks and then plays against the Falcons November 12th. There's a chance of a return November 5th against the Browns, if all goes well on the field. The team's only charge is to put him out there when he's physically and mentally ready to play and there's no rush. As quarterback coach Israel Wolfork told reporters, we're just worried about him getting back in the flow of things. He tore his ACL December 12th, ending his 2022 season. Now, here's where it gets ugly for Kyler. The early returns have been positive, but given the Cardinals' 1-5 spot and given how Murray now has a general manager in Monty Austinfort and a head coach in Jonathan Gannon who inherited him. That's not their quarterback. Okay, they didn't pick him. There are evaluations to be made. It's fair to say all options are on the table for the 2024 season. If Arizona has a top pick, it needs to know what it has in Murray in its system with its coaches in order to properly evaluate whether to take a top QB and trade Murray. On his original $230.5 million contract that came before 2022, Murray has 5 years and roughly $182 million left. A very palatable contract with a signing bonus already paid. Okay, so the signing bonus is already paid. Maybe that's going to help. Trading a healthy Murray to the highest bidder would at least be something to consider for an organization that has collected draft picks and appears to be midway through a rebuild. All right, so everybody immediately, the big drive was Cardinals fans, and of course, considering where Arizona is in relation to USC, you can expect that they're wanting Caleb Williams. I know a lot of Patriots fans are wanting Caleb Williams. So things didn't go well last night, and it didn't go well visually either. Caleb Williams didn't appear to be his usual energetic self Saturday night against Utah. The Utes beat the Trojans 34-32, and it's the second straight loss for Lincoln Riley's team. USC now sits at 6-2, and the hope of getting to the college football playoff is now nothing more than a pipe dream. The season is unraveling after a 6-0 start against weak competition. Turns out playing teams with a spine and talent is a real plot problem for Caleb Williams and company. Well, in the NFL, they all got spines and they all got talent on defense. Well, he looked like he wanted to be anywhere else on the planet other than playing Utah. The Heisman winner was shown on the broadcast after suffering his second straight loss, and his expression and body language speaks for itself. So, let's look.
But can't say enough. Kyle's right. Is. That young man is a warrior. His stare looks like it could cut glass right now. Downstairs, Allison with Bryson Barnes.
Thank you guys so much.
Okay, so he looked kind of disconnected, kind of miserable. And he goes on to talk about all that energy and what happened to it. Of course, we know the fan, Notre Dame fan, ran up to him. I actually thought Caleb handled that situation pretty well, you know. I mean, that situation could go worse at some point. You know, one of these football players could knock a fan right out, you know. And in this day and time, to be quite honest with you, you don't know what a fan's going to do. I mean, you can't act like they might not do something at this point. You never know. Point is, if you're an Arizona fan, you've got to ask yourself, we've got a quarterback now that there's been a lot of, and look, this is from people on the team and former teammates. All right, Steve Keim isn't even high on his quarterback that he drafted. When his ex-GM is not even high on Kyler Murray. So now the question is, do you draft another quarterback that could potentially have issues with demeanor and energy and how they conduct and carry themselves, theoretically, in times of stress and drama? Because you already got one of those. Now, one could argue Caleb Williams is more talented than Kyler Murray. And the one thing I know, he certainly is bigger, okay? He's a bigger QB. He is more of a 6 3/4, 6'1", all right? Whereas Kyler's 5'11", really, Kyler's like 5, maybe almost 5'11", almost 5'11". And yeah, Kyler's thick, but he's not thick like Russell. And he's certainly not thick like Caleb. And Caleb can move too. But there's starting to be some statistics, like I said earlier, that are starting to bear out that Caleb Williams might not be the slam dunk. I was listening to a pod the other day. I think it was Todd McShay and Ryan Russillo was on with Ryan Russillo. And, of course, McShay, he's my favorite draft analyst. And, you know, they're starting to talk up other quarterbacks now. All right. And that there may be a few teams that are actually starting to believe that Drake may be the guy. He's certainly a more prototypical kind of quarterback, right? But it's about to be interesting in Arizona. It's about to be interesting. Number one, what if Kyler comes back? Let's say he's great. And let's say you win three or four games, five games. And all of a sudden, you fall out of the top four or whatever. You know, you blow the draft pick. Is that something you want to do? I do have to agree with one thing. You've got to show that he's healthy if you're going to get anything for him on a trade. But who trades for him? That's the other thing. Who is going to trade for Kyler Murray? I don't know. It's getting rather interesting. Man, I just like to see better demeanor out of my quarterbacks. You know, I really do. I know it's a tough spot, but still. Yeah. Tell me what you think. Peace. I'm out. Till next time.
Thanks for watching the show. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Be sure to tune in next time on Black and White Sports.